when I first joined the solar career, I thought I would be dealing 100% with the power. And then I realized you're also a farmer. We are at the Chisago Solar Site in Chisago County, Minnesota.
We're here amid acres and acres of flowering habitat for bees and birds. The project here is demonstrating a variety of different stewardship practices that happen to be operable within the power plant. Low-growing meadows, grazing with sheep, tending beehives outside the fence. These are all ways to have dual-use solar.
At Enel, one of our core values is creating sustainable projects and helping the environment, helping our local communities. And what we'd like to do with this project is use this as a way to create a template for making our next projects better.
So we're testing out different types of plants to see how the rest of the world can use these plants to actually help the production and the health and well-being of their farms. Solar panels do not like heat. At 93 degrees Fahrenheit, a solar panel's production goes shooting down. So if you can cut off the reflection from the ground, you're actually stopping a lot of that heat from transferring up into the bottom of the panel, getting a higher production.
By 2030, we'll have more than 3 million acres of ground mount solar like this. So right now is the critical time to figure out how to do photovoltaic design in ways that provide more benefits to agriculture and ecosystems. And so looking around this project, you're able to see pollinator-friendly ground cover throughout the site, providing a baseline, a foundation of ecological value that then agricultural uses are built on top of. And obviously, there's incredible aesthetic appeal.
I think it's been a great opportunity for us to work with Enel because of their environmental, social, and community responsibility. We all need power, right? But when we make that power, we can do it in a way that benefits everybody around it. So why not plant it in pollinator-friendly habitat? You know, there's all these different terms, but this, when we combine solar energy production with agriculture, it truly is a solar farm.
Farmers tend to think, just because of pictures in the media, that the solar panels do something harmful to the land. And what we're seeing with this project is that the solar can actually provide financing for high quality habitat, deep root systems that are improving the quality of the soil.
We're actually helping rejuvenate the soil that has been damaged from farming and from pesticides and herbicides and things like that. So we lease most of our land, and after the 20 years the plant will be operating, that soil has now been returned to its 1850 original condition.
It all goes back to sustainability. And so when we're creating this sustainable plant, it allows the stakeholders and the community leaders and the landowners that we work with to see Enel as a partner in the organization and not just a company that's gonna come in to build a plant and then leave. It definitely makes you appreciate what we're doing here. And it's not just laying down bare earth and putting up an industrial scale solar plant. We're really trying to incorporate this dual use solar. We have photovoltaic panels, but also we have this pollinator friendly solar so we can use the land much more efficiently.
Projects like this show that we can provide renewable energy even more affordably with more benefits so that the consumers, the buyers, get really excited about the clean energy and the conservation and the agriculture happening all in one place. We can have clean energy and we can have these beautiful flowering landscapes. And that kind of innovation that's connected to nature, that's connected to agriculture, that's connected to community, is tremendously exciting.